Reivers. The story of the Reivers dates from the 14th century and continues through into the late 17th century. It concerns the border between the two sovereign countries of England and Scotland. In those days, this border displayed all the characteristics of a frontier, lacking law and order. This meant cattle rustling, thieving, murder, arson, and pillaging were all common occurrences. Thieving, treachery, death, lawlessness. Cross-border raids, family versus family, the Scots and the English, divided loyalties. Just like today, there were celebrities of the time, the big names with great stories to tell, though not everyone lived that way. Today, we're going to be bringing you five short role plays highlighting the lives led, not just by big names that can what will, but by the ordinary folk of the Reivers' time, focusing on the characters and how their lives were affected by the time they lived in. The first story we're going to share with you today is perhaps not typical of the Reivers' age, but it does illustrate the violence of the time and the harsh punishments which could be meted out. Let's introduce you to Archie.
Good day to you. I'm Archie Graham, and I'm a bonnie Scotsman. I'm 2 years old. All I wanted was a quiet life for my sweetheart Mary. Mary, come on! I wasn't interested in the politics of the time.
Yes, but sadly, the politics of our time weren't interested in us.
Jesus took place in 1587, not long after Mary, Queen of Scots, was executed by Queen Elizabeth I of England. Tensions for the border were running high.
We all know what death is around here. We've had our fair share of raid and kill it. We get as good as we get. We have to survive. Sometimes we have to make pacts with the devil himself just to survive. This vast open country is harsh. It frightens me sometimes wondering where the next raid is coming from and if my cattle will be stolen.
Although my vassal is well defended and my kinsmen will help when the raids come, I can never really sleep soundly at night. You're always waiting for the worst to happen.
And it often does. The border's red. My dad told me about the battles like Flodden, the thousand of English and Scots who went out slaughtering each other. The king stripped of the dead of the battlefield. Afterwards, I
don't give a damn about English and Scots. What matters is the name you have as a borderer.
You're right. The people that matter the most to you are the ones that stick by the most. Doesn't matter where they come from.
We get rough from all sides. Sometimes English, like the Charlton from the North Fight, or the Robson, but just often by the Scotch from the other side of the border.
You soon find out who your friends are, and even then I'm not sure you can trust many past your own family.
The problem is, no one really keeps it from control. Not the earls, not the ones in the big castles, or the wardens which are supposed to keep control.
They look after themselves. But when they do try to lay down the law, we have to suffer their so-called rules.
Rules? Laws to themselves? They never think of us. You're right. Our Archie broke those rules. He was my only surviving child. But now the wardens have harmed him. For what? Not blackmail, murder, or reaving. But no. Instead, they hang him for loving their own lassie. It's rubbish, I tell you.
So what did he do?
Come, I'll tell you. Pop! Pop! Archie, quieting down, won't you? You'll waken the dead. But Da, I brought someone to meet you, won't you hurry up? Mary. Pop, this is Mary, the lassie I tell you. Didn't I tell you she was a real looker?
It's good to meet you, sir.
Hi, Mary, have a wee seat. Archie, over here. I told you, Sam, no good will come from this. She's English.
But, Dad, it was you who said family's more important than nationality.
I don't hold that against her, but the law does. We're Scots. The warden won't wait it.
Oh, Dad, no one cares about me and Mary.
I promise you, sir, we'll be careful. We just want to be together and happy. We won't cause any attention to ourselves.
The problem was that cross-border relationships were frowned upon, and cross-border marriage needed the permission of the warden, and it wasn't long before Archie and Mary were bringing in attention to themselves.
We'll have to tell him, Archie, we'll have to. It's not like we can keep a baby a secret, will it?
It'll be okay. We'll get married. He'll be alright.
Yeah, but he doesn't like me already.
It's not that. It's because you're English, that's all.
I can't help where I was born, can I?
That's not what I meant. It's the rules of what cross-border relations is worried about.
He likes you. Honest, he does.
And you don't think finding out he's going to be a granddad won't change that? And you know he has a devil of a temper.
Well, it's not like he's going to report us to the warden, is it? We're getting married, we're having a baby, and that's fine. Come on.
Quiet. It was asking almost the impossible to keep a marriage and a baby quiet.
So what news do you bring me? There's been another two raids by the rooks and they're saying sheep and cattle taken. Casualties? Not this time, just proud heart, I think.
Don't they know one raid just brings another in retaliation? I wish they could see one peace and an end to lawlessness, then someone has to stop.
Okay, collect your money from the gatehouse on the way out.
Oh wait, there's another matter. A marriage.
I knew nothing of an intended marriage. Who?
Archie Graham, son of James from Liddlesdale.
The woman?
Lady Fanning.
Lady Fanning, that name means nothing to me. Where is she from?
Paul's whistle.
English! That's against the law! And gives me just the opportunity I need to show who's in charge here. And to impose the law on these outlaws. I'll see them hung and impose some very much needed discipline on these godforsaken lands. You'll have extra money for this.
Meanwhile, Archie and Mary had their own plans.
So, we had your father's blessing.
And more. He's brought us some. He's given us some money. We can set up home nearby.
I'm a little surprised, and a big bit surprised. We'll still have to be careful, though.
Aye, but being with a lawyer around here, no one will give us up. I told you everything would be fine, didn't I?
The two of them went off over the border to live near Archie's dad. They were the only family he had, as all Archie's brothers and sisters had died before the age of five. They all hoped they would get away with it, but they were too insignificant for the wardens to bother with, but they were wrong.
On the door so that they could be locked from both the inside and out. Perhaps he foresaw a day when this might come to his advantage.
And of course, for the story of every Reiver, there is generally a warden somewhere determined to bring him to book, and in this case, it is the governor of Newcastle.
And it is the conflict between these two men which is central to our story.
I had run into the governor before, and he was starting to compromise my operation, so I decided that I wanted rid of him, once and for all. Even though I say so myself, I came up with the most ingenious plan, the first of which was an audacious robbery from the governor himself. He didn't see it coming, or the ending that I had planned.
Couldn't quite believe what he's done, coming to my home and stolen from
from me. I thought he was mad. He must have known we'd go after him. I should have been more careful, but I was angry. He formed the posse and set after him.
Come on!
Of course I knew they'd come after me, though I must admit, I thought I might get a day or two's head start. Instead, they were after me within the hour and with a dog to track me. We decided to split up to try and confuse them. You two, over there.
Come on!
We could see them at the top of the hill. There was only one man we wanted, Barnhill himself. I wasn't going to follow anyone else. I was determined to make him pay for humiliating me. Come on, the hill! Get on!
From Liddesdale.
His name was Sir Robert Keir.
I was the warden of the English Middle March, and I wanted to put an end to the lawless name. It has a more romantic name now, Reiving. But all it was, as far as I could see, was thieving and violence, and I was fed up with it. So I took 200 of my men to visit the Armstrongs and to give them a message. Enough was enough. It was time to become stuff of legend. And indeed, it's enough to have this man's deeds immortalized in song. Alec?
My name is Alec Quigley, and this is my story. Mine and that of my leader and friend, Warden Carey. In the oral tradition of time, but brought up to date, let us tell you the story.
Hard, but even though we didn't have much. The cartridge was wild, didn't we? But
needed to stick together.
Yes, the last we
should have. What's more, we needed his help, but as it was to turn out, he needed us too.
It was some time ago now that they took our horses and left us with an empty barn. I wish the devil could have their souls and let them blaze to hell. But it angered the warden greatly. Robert Carey was his name. He said Alec Ridley distressed his spear right through the middle of his belly.
There's the Reaver! Get back!
Back in time.
Jill.
They were a family called the Robsons. They were scarlets, bunch of crows.
Don't talk rubbish about my family!
Can't say that yourself!
That's a horrible thing to say!
Shush!
And why is it that surprised me? Sit down and let me finish. As it happens, the Robsons weren't too well fed either. Well, it smells good at least.
I'm starving.
What's this? No much me in it. It's the second time this week.
It's not my fault. You'll have to go out and bring something back. We've only got a few sheep left. We need to buy a bit more to sort so we can sort them for the winter.
We've been out 2 nights running.
But what have you come back with? Nothing. You're useless.
Well, we got it in the Charles' game. There's nothing left from coming. After the crisis, we did a bit of a dump last week.
Good try flying over in Middlesdale. Good pickings over there.
Better bring something back.
All right, we'll try.
Steal them! Silence!
him my will, and I'm a border reaver. A notorious border reaver, some would say. The most famous border reaver, others would say. Me and my bairns like to undertake large-scale raids, up to 300 of us at a time, targeting whole areas, not just individual farms or homes. Oh yes, I'm someone to be reckoned with, but tomorrow I'm going to Carlisle to meet the wardens as part of Truce Day.
Elfers, please.
So it's tomorrow?
Yes, Willie, told you. There's nothing to worry about.
Well, I don't like it.
These truce days are important, and let us talk in safety and do deals and such like.
You can't trust the English.
Yes, and they say the same of us. That's why we have the truce days.
And Will trusts them.
No, of course he doesn't. That's why the truce day was called. No one would dare break the truce. They have too much to lose.
Well, I don't like it.
So you said, now shut up and let's go find 17.
Meanwhile, at Carlisle Castle.
But won't that break the truce?
It's too good a chance, Miss, like cutting a head of snake. Get Will and get the other Reavers to have a lesson. So let's get him when he's alone.
So where do we get him then?
After the meet, when he's on his way back to Morton Ring.
As if he's not alone?
He won't have his men with him, so it shouldn't be a problem. I want him alive to show an example. Anyone else? Kill him!
Yes, sir!
Later the next day after the meeting, on the road to Kenmore Will's home, Morton Rick, north of Carlisle.
I found it and a good result, Jim.
I bet Carlisle is just quite the next time we visit.
Indeed. Anyway, Morton Rick is just 5 minutes that way. I'll be seeing.
There they are, drop them!
Kenmore Will, the Lord's Grove wants to see you, so you're coming back to Carlisle with us. Pillaging days are behind you.
But this is an outrage! It's truce day! You can't do this!
We're doing it, so shut up!
My men will never allow this!
By the time we hear about it, you'll be locked up in Carlisle Castle. That'd be the end. No one will find you there. It'd be suicide! On your feet!
It's been nearly a month. The English won't even talk about his release.
I warned you. I warned him, but no one would listen to me.
Now that doesn't help them, does it?
No, it doesn't. Nor does your bickering. Now what we have to do is think about what we're going to do.
To do? What is there to do? Don't hang him soon.
Is he definitely still there? Aye, in a dungeon in the castle, by himself. They're still scared of him, see? Scared of us too. Scared of a rescue attempt. They'll hang him soon. We need to move quickly and decisively.
Well, you have a map. Have you a plan?
Oh yes. Gather your men. We go to work. He's taken the table with his hands. He guard the red wine, spring on heat. Now Christ's curse on my head, he said, but avenge the Lord's scroll on me. Oh, is my bassinet a widow's carriage, or my lance one in the willow tree, or my arm a lady's lily pond, that an English lord should like me?
Do you know the plan?
No, but he's had time. They don't nickname him the bold and quick for nothing, you know. It'll work.
And let's go get ourselves ready then. Come on.
Outside Carlisle Castle.
You have the money?
Here. You'll get their ass off there and make sure the door's open.
Oh, you can trust me.
Wah-ha-ha-ha!
What the hell? 9th of April 1596, it was dark and stormy. All the border burns and rivers were in spate. The winds blew shrewd and chill through the glens of Liddlesdale, and sleet drifted down the teeth of the gale. The trees that grew so thick around Woodhouse Lee bent and cracked and sent extra drenching showers of rain down on the steel jacks of a band of horsemen who carefully picked their way underneath them into the south. In the woods somewhere in the borders,
Well, all farmers really. All wanted to help Will. All wanted to avenge
expression of their thoughts, and although they well knew the hour of the dawning, each one of them might be claiming the hospitality of 6 feet of English soil, their hearts were light. To them, the supreme was up was like the sound of the huntsman's horn in the ears of a thoroughbred hunter.
Carlisle Castle was a strong castle, strongly garrisoned. It can make a rhythm in English towns of both attempt indeed. But fear was a thing unknown to the border reavers, and the flower of the world was opened at night. Close on his horse's heels, Wattle Garden, Walter Buckle of Goldilands, and Kinmont's own four stalwart sons, Jock, Francie, Geordie, and Sandy. As the dark night hours wore on, sleet and wind were reinforced by a thunderstorm.
When the besiegers reached the castle, they found some of the watch asleep, and the rest sheltering in stores from the storm. The outside of the castle was left to take care of itself.
Where's the gate? Round here, let's pray it's open.
It won't matter. We could kick it down in this weather. The guards would never hear it.
Drifting sleet, growling thunder, and the wails of the wind drowned all sounds of the assault. The door was indeed open, and soon there was no further need for concealment. For the lower court of the castle was theirs. The guards started up to find sword blades at the... Two of them left dead, and the rest were sweetly empowered.
There's the English! Get them!
The ball is complete. I have much to thank you for, but at what cost my rescue?
None. Save your two English jailers.
Shall we kill the others?
No. My escape will be tormented after a school. To murder his men will simply increase the price in our heads and the likelihood of our murderers while we sleep. But in that case, we should leave now and in a hurry.
Come on!
Not far from Long Town.
Okay, right. meeting. Get you to stand. We'll let mums and dads take some photos and stuff before we tidy up, all right? So, can you stand?
Oh, we'll see.
Come on, England!
Jay, do you mind one more time?
We are